Whatever group that you belong to and you say, well, maybe it's not for me because I'm not well represented, isn't that the reason you should be there? Because even if you're not well represented, if you are here, you're more rare. You're more relevant.
One of the things that made me hesitant, how would I be received? Would I be an outsider? Would I be comfortable? But I didn't have a concern with relatability.
I think if you'd asked me right when I graduated from undergrad, one of the things that I would put on top of my I will not be this list would have been an attorney. I felt pretty confident by the time that I decided on law school that that was where I wanted to be and what I wanted to do.
I didn't necessarily see it in myself when my employer sat me down and encouraged me to do this. I didn't know what to expect in law school. Once I was admitted, things started to make more sense to me.
I actually didn't think I was good enough to go to law school because I was a bad reader and even worse writer. But now that I'm getting my JD, even if I don't practice law, the doors are wide open.
I've really got connected to a group of thinkers that thought outside of the box in terms of the law and questioning and interrogating.
I've gone from one interest to another. It's something that connects me with members of an interdisciplinary community. It allows me to like think really creatively and in an interesting way. It doesn't have to follow a sort of regimented line. You can have an arc in your life, right? Maybe what you do is you go practice social justice for a while and then you want to teach. Maybe you want to be a school teacher.
I actually told everyone that I would never do criminal law, but I think that experience in the classroom and being a teacher definitely has changed the way I approach law school and approach being a lawyer.
If it's something that you think you want to do, I highly recommend doing it. And there's always going to be people that dissuade you. But ultimately, you just have to figure out if it's what's right for you.
It is increasingly common that when people are graduating from law school, they are not necessarily going to practice in a white shoe law firm. And a lot of those opportunities that are coming up in non-traditional pathways are related to things directly related to the law.
Talk to different people. Don't only talk to practicing lawyers. Talk to people who are in other areas who use their degree for a variety of things, entrepreneurs, folks that work in-house counsel. I think a lot of people have a monolithic view of what it means to be a lawyer.
The way that I think about a law degree is it teaches you a way of thinking, a process of solving problems, and that process can be used by somebody in almost any career.
Diversity in approach, in experience, in thought makes for a better system. If we are trying to work to become a better nation, it requires us as lawyers from different backgrounds and different experiences to work to the full extent of our profession.
All the reasons you think that you're not good enough are the reasons why you are. If you look at the legal profession and say that it's not for me, if you're ever on the fence and those things scare you, that's the reason to do it.